glorifies, glory in this, that he understandeth and knoweth me. And that's us, brothers. All right, that's us that are in this truth. We know and we understand the Heavenly Father. We know his name. We know his son's name. We know his true characteristics. We know that he controls everything on the planet Earth, whether it be righteousness or wickedness. We know the Heavenly Father. We understand the Heavenly Father. That is the most powerful knowledge there is, man. There's nothing that can top it. That's what I'm trying to impart to you in this video. That's what I'm trying to show you. Okay? But let him that glorifieth glory in this. And you know what? This knowledge that we're getting will kick in. You know when it's going to kick in? When all hell breaks loose. Matter of fact, let's read this. Let's read this in Psalms. Where the Heavenly Father looks down to see. Well, let's read it. Okay? Psalm 14, beginning at the first verse. Psalm of David, right? The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. And the majority of people, in reality, they don't believe in God. They don't even know God. They don't know him. They don't know the Heavenly Father, period. Okay? Let's just put it out there. Even the ones that have that zeal. What has the scripture say, you know, concerning our people? They have a zeal. Right? Romans the 10th chapter. They have a zeal. Matter of fact, let's get it. Romans the 10th chapter. Oh, they got a zeal. They're in church every so-called Sunday. Who the hell told them to worship the Heavenly Father on just Sunday? Which Sunday goes back to the sun god. In reality, they don't even realize they're worshiping the sun god, which the Heavenly Father himself said not to do, not to worship the sun. But there you go. Romans the 10th chapter, the first verse. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Heavenly Father for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record. Now, the Apostle Paul bear them record. I mean, he was checking them out. He was looking at them. He said, for I bear them record, certain Israelites, that they have a zeal of the Heavenly Father, but not according to knowledge. So you can have a zeal of the Heavenly Father, but is it according to knowledge? Do you have the real truth? Do you truly understand the Heavenly Father? Do you truly know how to worship him? As it is written, the Heavenly Father seeketh for the true worshipers. This is what Yahweh Shai said. He gave us a scoop. He said, look, the Heavenly Father is looking for the true worshipers to worship him in spirit and in truth. Now, how many people are doing that? Honestly doing that. There you go. For they being ignorant of the Heavenly Father's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, i.e., or example, those so-called churchgoers, doesn't matter what denomination, and even certain Israelites, right? They being ignorant of the Most High's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of the Heavenly Father, the true righteousness of the Heavenly Father. And for you to do that, you'd have to really know the Heavenly Father. You'd have to know that he deals with both sides, good as well as evil. So let's get back to Psalms, right? The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There's none that doeth good, right? Now here's the point. The Lord looketh down from heaven, and this is every day. The Lord looks down from heaven, right? The Heavenly Father Yahweh looks down from heaven upon the children of men. That's everybody. To see if there were any that did understand and seek the Heavenly Father. Now who, come on, who are the ones that understand and seek the Heavenly Father? Brothers, us. Can you see how we are above average now? Because the majority of the people of the world do not know or understand the Heavenly Father. There's a scripture where it says the Heavenly Father is a power that hideth himself. But the ones he's revealed to is us. That's why in 1 Thessalonians it speaks about, 1 Thessalonians speak about how, well, let's get it. Let's get it so I don't butcher it. 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter. And beginning at the 4th verse, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that that day should overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light. What day is it talking about? The day when Yahweh Shai returns. The majority of the people of the world don't even understand that day. Okay, what's going to happen? transpire on that day. But that's another video for another time. Ye are all the children of light. And the greatest light is to understand and know the Heavenly Father. There is no greater light than to know and understand His Son.